time, languages change. Almost everyone knows this, even if they aren't that interested in linguistics. It's the reason people in Spain and Italy don't both still speak Latin, it's the reason Americans sound different from British people, and it's the reason that high school students get so frustrated with Shakespeare. And yet, when you look at the speed that these changes would have had to have taken place at, it can seem a little weird sometimes, at least to me. Like, around 600 AD, whatever people in the former Roman Empire spoke was still probably similar enough to Latin that they could at least understand classical Latin texts. But in 813 AD, the Catholic Church ordered priests to preach in whatever the vernacular was, mostly because they realized that no one could understand Latin anymore. Assuming an average generation length of, I don't know, 25 years? That means that in just 9 generations, people's speech changed enough to make a formerly intelligible language unintelligible, and that on average during this period, people's speech was 1/9 as different from their parents' speech as 600s vulgar Latin was from 800s Proto-French or Italian or whatever. I mean, I guess this is kind of reasonable, I mean it's not that fast to change, but I don't know about you guys, but I tend to perceive my speech as being identical to that of my parents. I mean, I know there's the stereotype of teenagers speaking differently from their parents, but when I listen to adults in my area and fellow teenagers in my area, I don't notice a big difference, or most of the time, any difference at all. Because of this, I had always assumed that right here, right now, language just isn't changing. However, that worldview ended as soon as I started learning about something called the Cot-Caught Merger, and realized that there's actually a sound shift currently in transition in American English right now, which I think can teach us a lot about how people who participate in the natural evolution of language perceive what's going on. Okay, so first of all, what exactly is the Cot-Caught Merger? Well, as the name implies, all it is a sound change where you pronounce the vowel in cot as in the past tense of to catch, the same as the vowel in cot as in something you sleep in. And not just those two words, the vowel in talk, small, fall, tall, and any other word with that vowel in it is pronounced exactly the same as the vowel in rock, doll, clock, bomb, etc. As you might have noticed by now, my speech exhibits the merger, and if you're thinking to yourself, what the hell are you talking about, all of those words are normally pronounced with the same vowel, congratulations, you have the merger. The merger is mostly a US and Canada thing, although it also occurs in some dialects of British English. Originally, no one had the merger. Cot and cot were always pronounced differently, which is why they're spelled differently, but over time, people started pronouncing the two vowels the same in certain regions. It actually started in 3 different places in the US completely independently of each other, in the western US, in northeastern New England, and in western Pennsylvania. It's unclear when exactly it started, but today it's spread to cover a lot of the US. Pretty much anyone from west of Iowa will probably have the vowels fully merged, and the merger in western Pennsylvania has spread through West Virginia and into eastern Kentucky. However, most of the Midwest, most of the Mid-Atlantic states, and almost all of the southern US still pronounce the two vowels differently. Now, when I learned about this, it was the first example of different dialects of English having different inventories of vowels I had ever heard, and I thought it was really cool, so I started to tell my parents about it. But I decided that first I'd test them to see if they had the merger too. Their speech sounds exactly like mine, so I was confident they'd also have the merger, but to my bafflement, both of them had the sounds fully unmerged. But, you know, maybe I was just weird, so I went and tested my sister, but then she had them fully merged too. All this time, I had been talking to my parents, thinking that I learned how to speak from them, and therefore my speech would be exactly the same as theirs, when it turns out the way I talk is actually part of a new change in the evolution of English. Naturally, I started wondering whether I picked up the merger from TV and movies and such, or from my friends, and I was also wondering what the status of the merger was in my hometown of Nederland, Colorado, so I decided to conduct a survey of people at my school to see how they pronounce these vowels, and the results ended up being really interesting. So, considering this is the first of my videos where I share original research of my own with you guys, I feel the need to include this disclaimer. Disclaimer! I have no formal education in linguistics. I have no experience at all conducting linguistic surveys. This was not a randomly chosen sample, it was an arbitrarily chosen sample. I probably did not follow good procedure in conducting this survey. I have no freaking idea what I'm doing, and no one should ever, ever, ever take me seriously, ever. Alright, got that out of my system. Moving on, I surveyed a total of 18 students and 11 teachers, and the first thing that should be talked about is that there is a lot of variation from person to person. The way I conducted the survey was I recorded people saying these words and asked them to tell me if they pronounced some of the vowels differently from others, and if so, which ones. And then I asked them to say cot and cot and tell me if those were pronounced differently. I thought most people would either say all the vowels the same and say that all of the vowels were the same, or they would correctly identify which are pronounced which way. What wound up happening was 11 people had the two vowels fully merged, and 6 people had them fully unmerged, but 10 people did something where I couldn't really classify them as either. Some people said that all of them had exactly the same vowel except for one word, which was pronounced differently. Some people said that there was a difference between how the vowels were pronounced but got completely wrong which were which, or just refused to even try to figure out which were which, complaining that they couldn't tell. Some people pronounced all of the vowels in the first set of words the same, but then went and pronounced cot and cot differently. And some people did the exact opposite, correctly identifying which words were pronounced which way, but pronouncing cot and cot the same. 2 people I asked were adamant that all of these vowels were pronounced exactly the same, but when I listened to them read them, I heard an extremely distinct difference. Also, I thought it might be the case that students tend to say them the same while teachers say them differently, and that did end up being true to an extent, but I also asked people where they came from, and exhibiting the merger is much more closely correlated with growing up here in Netherlands than it is to being a student. So the fact that teachers tend to have the vowels unmerged while students tend to have them merged is probably just because teachers are much more likely to have grown up in some other state. A lot of modern research on the merger shows that this kind of variation is really common all over the country. I've read that some people have merged the vowels in some words, but not in others, and also that some people say them differently but think they're saying them the same, or vice versa, saying them the same while thinking that they're saying them differently. And yet, all across the US, almost no one even knows that the merger exists. Even when you say the vowels differently, you probably say them so similarly that you don't even notice when other people say them the same, and as such, people who say them the same don't notice that you say them differently. The merger is becoming more and more common in American television and media, and some people predict that eventually the entire US will say the two vowels the same. Meanwhile, none of us even realize that it's happening. This, right here, is probably how most sound changes in the world happen. Slowly, with enormous variation from person to person, and subtly enough that no one even realizes that it's going on. Sometimes we don't need to look at historical records to figure out how language changes and evolves. Sometimes we just need to look around. What about you guys? Do you pronounce cot and cot the same? Let me know in the comments, and come back next time when I talk about one of the most famous sound changes of all time, Grimm's Law.